and literally just almost sunk himself.
Hey, you guys, I'm here.
Yeah. So, you know, he says he blames drunken speech on mixing alcohol and meds. And, you know, we have a couple of sound bites here. And, you know, look, it's probably, you know, as time goes on, the truth of the matter is it's probably not that big a deal. But at the same time, it sure is a window into this guy's character. And everybody's so willing, so frightened to death that it happened so quick, so soon before the season. You got 2 weeks in the first game. It's two weeks.
In 2 weeks, right?
That's now, it. This is an organization. This is a football juggernaut, USC. Their program has suffered because of Reggie Bush's behavior. And for 4 years, they were punished, and they were kept from having a full load of recruits and new football players. And now they just now come out from underneath all of this and trying to gain some sort of momentum in the program. And that means the coach having a full squad, having a balanced squad, having depth, which they've always had problems with in the last 4 years. And you know, you've got this guy who was brought in here by Pat Hayden, you know, a couple of years ago to take over for you know, Lane Kiffin, who was a disaster, and so now you have this guy suddenly showing up at the school function, this pep rally last Saturday, I think it was, and he just drunk, and
he's a college coach now, yeah,
and he says. And he says, the way I acted was irresponsible. There are things we're going to work to work on for me. And you know, he just stuttered and stammered. And he sounded in his press conference like he was still drunk. And he might be shell-shocked because, you know, people don't buy this stuff a lot. You know, people in the alumni at SC schools, they don't like the guy showing up and showing his rear end like that. And he said it was a mix of alcohol and meds. And when he was asked about the meds, he declined to talk about it. Now, I'm going to tell you something. My coach shows up like that. I'm Pat Hayden.
I want to talk to you.
I'm going
to
tell you something. I want to know what the meds were. I want to know what kind of a coach. Do I have a lunatic on my hands here? Is this going to happen again?
Well, I want to talk to you about that. You know Pat Hayden. He was with the Ram organization.
Yeah.
He's been with USC for a long time. I wonder how he handles this whole thing. And we'll talk about that and a whole lot more here on the PM Show Weekend Edition on Sports. I'm Michael Horn. That's Fred Dreyer. Follow Fred on Twitter. Fred_Dreyer. D-R-Y-E-R. Fred_Dreyer. Email him. FredDreyer@crntalk.com.
What would an extra $250 a month mean to you? For some, it's a little financial breathing room. For others, it's a car payment, a home repair, or help with college tuition. Hi, I'm Jay Farner, president of Quicken Loans, and I've got some great news if you're looking to save money on your mortgage. All it takes is a simple phone call to Quicken Loans at 800-QUICKEN to see if you qualify for the government's Home Affordable Refinance Program, or HARP. Folks who refinance with HARP can save an average of $250 a month. That's $3,000 a year. Our home loan experts fully understand the HARP guidelines, and they'll walk you through our streamlined process. And for 5 years in a row now, J.D. Power has ranked Quicken Loans highest in the nation in customer satisfaction. And this year, for the first time, they've also ranked us highest in mortgage servicing. Call 800-QUICKEN or visit quickenloans.com.
Visit jdpower.com for award information. Important terms and conditions apply. Call us for cost information. Equal housing lender. Licensed in all 50 states and MLS number 3030.
PM Show Weekend Edition on Sports. I'm Michael Horn, the star of our show, Fred Dreyer. So, Fred, let's talk about this here. The USC head coach at this pep rally or whatever it was steps up to the microphone, obviously inebriated, and we got some sound bites on to play. But the Pat Hayden is the athletic director at USC. What does he do here? Obviously, he fired Lane Kiffin September 29th in 2013 after the year part after a loss to Arizona State. He didn't hire another coach despite a 6-2 record after Kiffin's firing, and that was Ed Orgeron. Is that what his name?
Yeah, Ed Orgeron.
Orgeron. And then on the brink of the 2015 season now, the coach, Steve Sarkisian, has to address and stuff, and so he has this address. What does Hayden do now? Does he dump him? Does he keep him? Does he? What would you do?
Well, I mean, what would I do is probably not what Pat Hayden's doing, and that is he immediately supported his coach. He said it was just a transgression, and the coach apologized, and he said, okay, then you got to stand up and do this right away and head this off. So he did, and he answered questions, whatever those questions were. And I'm a big believer, man. You know, when something like this happens, it opens the gates to ask him anything about what's going on in his personal life. This you're putting the school is asking this coach to go into homes and say to the parents, "Let me have your kid. I'm going to mold.
This is an educational
program.
I'm going to
mold
right.
him into a." So so this is a very serious deal. And I don't know how much that Pat had to persuade the alumni, the key boosters,
to keep him
or to.
Well, they say there's two schools of thoughts here within the USC athletic department. They said there's kind of a split. Some wanted action, like you're saying, to combat what they believe was a long-time drinking culture within the football program. And then there was another side that applauded Sarkisian for being politically incorrect and acting, as they say, real on stage, football's version of Donald Trump. I don't buy that one.
That's all BS.
That's a BS
one. That's bad form.
That is bad. Not when you're in an educational facility here, I'm telling you. You want your kids to be there. You already had all these sanctions. You mentioned Reggie Bush. And I don't just blame Reggie Bush. I blame the whole organizational department there, including the coach at the time, Pete Carroll. He knew what was going on. He could have stopped this stuff. They knew what was happening. But they decided to all fly and leave and get out of the organization. And then, you know, there's always Reggie Bush on there. Yeah, he did it, but the other guys knew about it. I think you don't have that hidden from the culture in schools anyway.
Yes. It's still an educational facility, and these young kids, and they're impressionable as heck. But look, Sarkisian is—I don't know what kind of a coach he is. You know, people are saying, "Well, he's a great coach, and he's a terrific recruiter." You know, I always hear that, and I don't know what that means. I mean, is he persistent? Does he make a lot of phone calls? Does he drive to Las Vegas and parts unknown on the holidays to recruit kids? I don't know how that works, but I do know that you know, when a head coach does something like this. It's just a window into other problems, you know.
I agree with you, and I
will say this: that I may not say you're fired, but what I will tell him is, you better come clean and let the school know if you're on medication of some sort.
That's
true, and you can't be put in the custody. Given custody of these kids, if you've got some sort of a problem, psychological, emotional problem that we don't know about. And if this is a window into that, then let's talk about it.
Well, this could be a problem at USC because, according to a column in the Daily News, when Lane Kiffin, when he was as the coach, he wanted alcohol in the locker room, and then the interim coach Ed Orgeron came in and he took it out. Sarkisian brought alcohol back in the locker room.
He wants alcohol in the locker room.
Yes, it says the former coach Lane Kiffin wanted alcohol in the locker room when he took over the program, but it was eliminated by the interim coach Ed Orgeron, and then in brought it back. Now, the issue, they say, it's long. Legendary coach John McKay had a booth named after him at the Julie's restaurant next to the campus in the 60s and the 70s.
That's off campus.
Yeah, it's off campus. This is in the locker room they're talking about now.
What is that? That's stupidity.
So, and now that you got the media.
They're not 21 years old.
Cell phones take pictures of this. The critics say that after 2012, when they were playing the Sun Bowl, Kiffin had a large scrape on his forehead, and they said Kiffin suffered the cut when he fell in the hotel after drinking. So I think the management here, or the athletic director, has to step in and stop
this. That's just
human.
That's not a subscription for disaster just for USC. That's every school.
I agree.
That's every walk of life. You're always going to get that. But what's interesting is why would you subscribe to, if you're the athletic director, to alcohol on campus?
Exactly.
Why would you put alcohol?
Why would you do that
after the games or after practice? Just have a beer together. That's not something you do.
You're right.
That you would be fired for.
But apparently,
I would fire a coach.
Well,
I would if I was the athletic director.
We should go to a press conference and ask these.
I would say, do you have alcohol on campus? You do. Who brought it in there? Well, I said it was okay. You're fired.
Yep.
Goodbye.
There's a well-known USC.
If you're that stupid, really, come on.
It is. There's a USC player, well-known, was asked not to be identified, said he lost respect for Sarkisian. He said, quoting now, "We would not be allowed to act in that manner, and neither should a coach," he said.
That's right.
And I agree with that.
That's correct.
So there you have it.
That's correct. You know, I mean, we all, that's an emotional sport. And if you don't know that, I don't think I should go to this pep rally and take my pants off and do stupid things, then you're an idiot. You shouldn't be a coach.
It's true. We got some sound. We'll play the next segment there so you can actually hear what's going on. But I think for my money here, the athletic director, in this case Pat Hayden, should step in there and, you know, this is it. No more alcohol in the locker room. This is the deal. Go next door.
Well, again,
go to the hotel, whatever you're going to
do. That calls for a follow-up investigation by a newspaper that cares about getting and solving a problem and bringing these things to light. You know, a kid can get alcohol no matter where he goes, certainly, in the dorm room or whatever it might be. That's fine, but you can't have it condoned by a coach. You can't have it used as a bonding, rallying effect for kids. And I've seen it done different places. And everybody has their place where they go after practice, after school, and sit down. And none of these kids are, 21 years of age.
You're right.
They're 18, 19, 20 years of age. There's no reason to have alcohol on campus in a locker room in a football facility. You're an idiot, and you should be fired on the spot if you do. Now, Sarkisian has mental problems, and he's that dumb to mix it with alcohol. See, the first thing that they give you if you have some sort of a psychotropic drug that you have to take because you're off balance,
or you need it,
cannot drink alcohol. Right. It's on the label.
It says it right there.
You don't have to. What do you have to follow people around and remind them? Hey, remember, Sark, whatever you do, don't have a beer with these lewds I'm going to give you here. Yeah, and so you walk around. And,
maybe they'll hire you to do that. You just could follow people around.
They
and remind
should hire
them.
Me. I just say, are you on Quaaludes right now? Are you on Prozac?
You would ask the
How
question.
How about Zoloft? You on Zoloft? What's your prescription? 50 milligrams of Zoloft? That'll
PM Show Weekend Edition on
you'll
sports.
Grab a hatchet.
Follow Fred on Twitter. Fred_Dreyer, Dreyer. You're experiencing pain, back pain, shoulder, elbow, or hand pain from a sports injury. If so, schedule a visit with Dr. Michael Sheps, the leading expert in laser therapy for pain management. Call 310-873-4422 or go to drsheps.com. Experience Epic T, the breakthrough laser therapy system that Dr. Sheps developed to make you pain-free in less time. Laser therapy is a non-invasive, safe, and effective in-office procedure that penetrates deep into your skin without damaging the tissue. It perfectly targets areas of pain to promote fast, natural healing. Relax your muscles, ease muscle spasms, joint stiffness, and arthritis pain while increasing blood circulation. For over 25 years, Dr. Sheps has helped Olympic athletes and sports enthusiasts alike get back in the game. Schedule your visit with Dr. Sheps at his Brentwood office in California. Call 310-873-4422 or visit drsheps.com. That's drsheps.com, 310-873-4422.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. Attention men who've taken Androgel or any other testosterone therapy products. Androgel or other low T products have been linked to heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, even death. Scientific studies indicate that the use of testosterone therapy products may double a man's risk of heart attack. If you or a loved one took Androgel or a testosterone therapy product and suffered from a heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, or any other cardiac event, you might be entitled to financial compensation. You have rights, and you need to let us fight for your rights. And you pay no fees unless we win. So call the Tort Attorneys right now. 800-557-7921. 800-557-7921. That's 800-557-7921. Cases may be referred to participating law firms in your jurisdiction.
When you really want Italian food, you've got to go to Columbo's. Columbo's Italian Steakhouse and Jazz Club. Colorado Boulevard, Eagle Rock. It's that little neighborhood place you wish was down the street from you. Good afternoon, Mr. Phelps. Southern California is inundated with restaurants vying to vanquish Columbo's, and none have succeeded. Your mission, Jim, is to further enlighten the populace regarding Columbo's and their absolutely delicious steaks. Seafood so fresh it'll make you blush. Family Italian specialties that put the competition to shame. Jazz every night along with their world-renowned meatballs. The code words for this assignment, Mission Impasto Fagioli. As always, should you or any of the force be caught, the Secretary will disavow any knowledge of your actions, but looks forward to seeing you at that little neighborhood place you wish was down the street from you, Columbo's. This disc will self-destruct in 5 seconds. Good luck, Jim, and mangia!
PM Show, Weekend Edition on Sports. I'm Michael Horn. The star of our show is the Sultan of Safeties. Two safeties in one game. All-pro defensive end. Started with the New York Giants. Did an illustrious job with the Los Angeles Rams, where he completed his career and then became the legendary actor. I'm talking about the one and only Fred Dreyer. Fred, you've got a new TV series coming up this fall on TNT. I hope you plug that tonight whenever you're on other radio stations. And that, of course, will be Agent X. Am I right?
It's Agent X. It's a Sharon Stone show, and it's action, 1 hour, you know, CIA spy type of stuff.
It's good.
But it's good. Great people. And so, yeah, I'm on that, and they've invited me. I did a couple of shows, and it's a recurring character. And if the show, which comes out, I think, in November on TNT, if it has any merit and he gets any legs, then maybe I'll be a part of it. Yeah.
Excuse me. Is Coach Steve. I just wonder if you talk about me some more. I love it when you talk about me on the show. So if you could, I just sit back here in the corner and listen to you talk about me. Apparently, Coach Sarkisian is here in the studio with us.
Let me. Where is he? Oh, geez.
Oh, here. Right behind you. It's really good.
Do we have a...
Yeah, we have sound bites here.
Well, let's hear it. I thought you were getting ready to play.
Here's Coach Sarkisian, and here he was at the... he was kind of off base here, Drew, using the terrible language.
Get ready to right on, baby! Let's go!
Can I hear him lead the pep rally one more time?
Get ready to right on, baby! Let's go!
Oh, yeah.
Once more, just to kind of get me in the spirit for football.
Get ready to right on, baby. Let's go!
Yeah, I just got everybody pumped up there a little.
Yeah, this is me. Thanks for playing that, Fred.
Well, he looked like he had a few things there. He probably dropped the F-bomb there. We had to bleep that out for you. Then he had the press conference. That's where you said he kind of talked about things, and he apologized for his behavior.
So first and foremost, I'd like to apologize for my behavior Saturday night. It was inappropriate. I feel bad for the University of Southern California. I feel bad for Max Nikias, Pat Hayden. I feel bad for our players, and I feel bad for my own kids that the way I acted was irresponsible and something that I obviously don't condone. I think the moral of the story is this. When you mix meds with alcohol, sometimes you say things and or do things that you regret, and I regret it. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for all of our fans and donors and all the people that were in attendance.
I made myself cry listening to that, Fred. It brought tears to my own eyes.
Sounded drunk then.
He did, didn't he, a little bit on that deal? And then they had comments, some of the team members making comments.
Bottom line for us is that's our head coach. You know, we're going to support him no matter what. You know, mistakes happen. Stuff happens. But at the end of the day, as a team, we've moved on. We put it past us. Me, Sua, the whole team, we've all made mistakes before. Stuff's happened. And he came to us as a man, apologized, looked us in the face, told us some things, and you know, that's hard to do. But at the end of the day, I think he earned more respect from us and a team. I think it brought us closer together.
How about that? You should do it more often.
Thank you, Billy.
Should do it more often, actually.
That's ludicrous. I'm telling you. It's how can you be... You know, and when he says the meds, and you said they asked him what the meds were, and he wouldn't say what they were. I mean, get this man some help and some treatment here. Make sure he could do. They took Rush Limbaugh off the air for a while. Come on, this guy's just the coach of USC. Give me a break here. It's really something else.
Well,
I gotta admit, it's a good story. It was good for about three segments on our show here today.
That's it. I'm done with him.
You're welcome, Fred. And you need something next week, I'll have a little nip of something else.
Yeah.
Thank you, Coach.
He just wants to get on with it and give SC a championship.
That's it. He wants to get on.
That's the only thing that matters, actually.
It's important.
Hey, listen, I'm looking at my page here.
Oh, look at that page. That's a nice one.
Steelers sign Michael Vick to a one-year backup deal with Ben Roethlisberger.
Wow. So and, Vick is backing up.
Yeah, so he gets a chance. He gets multiple chances as dog murderer. Remember that?
Yeah, I know.
He gets multiple chances, and Ray Rice,
who's beating up his wife.
Who punched his wife out in the elevator. One of the best in fighting inside left hooks I've seen in a while.
Careful.
Knocks out his wife, the girlfriend-to-be, and he was married to her, and then it's his girlfriend-to-be, right? Or was it his girlfriend to be?
They got married. Yeah.
So, but Ray is now the chance that Ray maybe not have the chance.
Not have a second chance.
Not have a second chance. I think he should.
No matter what it is.
I've heard him speak, and frankly, he's more convincing than Michael Vick was.
I believe so.
I saw Michael Vick as he got out of jail. I'm sorry, I have no dog.
Take it easy, Michael Vick. It's National Dog Appreciation Day, so be nice.
Do you owe the IRS money? Do you have years of unfiled returns? Has the IRS garnished your wages or put a lien against your house? The IRS has the power to make you pay back what they claim you owe and will stop at nothing to collect. If you are losing sleep over your IRS tax problem, there is a solution. Call Signature Tax now. Speak with our professionals and feel the weight of your tax burden lifted from your shoulders. Call 800-543-1427 for your free and confidential analysis on ending your tax nightmare. We can help get your life back on track and give you the fresh start you deserve. Our A-plus BBB-rated tax resolution team has over 125 years of combined experience to get you the best deal possible while stopping the IRS dead in their tracks. Call Signature Tax now at 800-543-1427. Call 800-543-1427. Again, that's 800-543-1427. 800-543-1427.
Experience a luxury boutique hotel escape in the heart of Laguna Beach, California. With the finest art gallery, shopping, dining, and nightlife just steps from your door. The heart of Laguna Beach, the edge of the sea. It's the Inn at Laguna Beach. Enjoy our comfortable rooms, blending the style of a timeless beach bungalow with the modern comforts of today. 70 newly appointed guest rooms and suites await you at the Inn at Laguna Beach. Then, relax at the rooftop bar, where you'll indulge in breathtaking views of the ocean. For dining, you'll find libations and local cuisine on the California coastline, including dining at the legendary Las Brisas, a Southern California landmark. The Inn at Laguna Beach. Footsteps from room to village to sea, located in the heart of Laguna Beach. The Inn is within walking distance of all that Laguna Beach has to offer. No car required. The Inn at Laguna Beach. 211 North Coast Highway in Laguna Beach, California. Call 800-544-4479 or visit innatlagunabeach.com.
Are you nearing eligibility for Medicare benefits? Then you know now is an important time in your life. Medicare benefits can be a complicated puzzle. You don't want to overpay for your Medicare coverage or get the wrong plan. Let Health Markets Insurance Agency help you. With one free phone call, a licensed insurance agent will help you select a Medicare plan that's right for you and your budget. If you're becoming eligible for Medicare, call today and learn how to get the most out of your benefits.
800-793-1960. 800-793-1960.
Health Markets Insurance Agency is the DBA or assumed name of InSphere Insurance Solutions, Inc., which is an authorized insurance agency in all 50 states and the District of Columbia. Not all agents are licensed to sell all products. Service and product availability varies by state.
Call 800-793-1960, 800-793-1960, 800-793-1960, 800-793-1960.
Welcome to Staples.
Hi, Staples guy. I need school supplies for my kids, and I can't spend a lot.
With Staples' 110% price match guarantee for back to school, find an item for less, and we'll match the price and give you 10% of the difference.
So I'll get the lowest price on backpacks?
Yes.
Notebooks?
Mm-hmm.
Calculators?
You bet.
Even?
Yep.
Nice.
Make low prices happen. Make 110% ready happen. Staples. Make more happen.
Price match plus the 10% difference discount valid at checkout for items from retailers operating online and retail stores or products sold and shipped by Amazon. Valid through 9/19/15. See store or staples.com for details.
AJ here from the Tee It Up Radio Network. Each week we cover the world of golf for you. Celebrating 18 years, Tee It Up continues to bring you fresh inside the ropes reporting and one-on-ones with Hollywood's most passionate golfers. So stay in the know with the Tee It Up show, Sunday morning, 6 to 8 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, live right here on CRN, Digital Talk Radio.
Catch the gang from Tee It Up on CRN 1, Sundays, 6 to 8 a.m. Pacific Time, 9 to 11 a.m. Eastern Time, right here on CRN, Digital Talk Radio.
PM Show, Weekend Edition on Sports. I'm Michael Horn, the star of our show, the one and only Fred Dreyer. Yes, that Fred Dreyer. Yeah. He'll have a new series, Agent X, coming up this fall, of course, from Hunter and Crisis last year, and he's a football legend. And before that, by the way, played baseball in college. He had a nice strapping right-hander, man. He could really bring it. Speaking of baseball, a little over 50 years ago, this last month, a big incident. I know you're a big Dodger fan, and there's a big Dodger-Giant rivalry. Remember that Juan Marshall, John Roseborough, Sandy Koufax bat incident where Juan Marshall hit catcher, one of the great baseball catchers of all time for the Dodgers, John Roseborough, in the head with a baseball bat?
1965.
Smacked him with it. That is really something. If you go to, by the way, our website, we got it up on YouTube for
today's show. It was a Sunday afternoon show. Game.
But you also can check us out. You go to Roku Box, buy one of those over at Costco, and you can see our show live. But I'm holding up the photo now of Koufax stepped in. I mean, here's a great pitcher, Sandy Koufax, trying to protect his catcher, John Roseborough. Marshall, that hothead, just came and smacked him on the head.
Yeah.
And then they played together later on. John Roseborough played together with Juan Marshall. But you can see Roseborough's head first off here where he had the big bandage up there on his head.
Well, the bottom photograph is both of them together.
Yeah, that's when they played together then, because Marshall finished his career on the Dodgers. But that was a crazy incident, wasn't it, as I recall? I think Marshall thought that Roseborough asked Koufax to throw at him. Was that what it was? He got upset about it?
50 years ago.
Were old enough to remember.
19 years ago.
50 years ago this weekend, and it was there. It was a brawl. There was a big rivalry between
the Dodgers. Yeah, I remember the day. It was a Sunday afternoon game. Yeah. I remember listening to it. It was actually on TV. I saw it.
Yeah.
Let's see. I mentioned Ray Rice, not getting another
chance. So that's it for my story?
Yeah,
I just want to say Juan Marshall also spoke at Johnny Roseborough's funeral, which was nice, saying goodbye and thank you. That was,
I come here to hit him again.
He said, Johnny's forgiving me was one of the best things that happened in my life.
So I'm going to hit him again.
He said, I wish I could have had John Roseborough as my catcher.
Yeah. How does that make their catcher feel?
Well,
It was, wasn't it Hank Haller or Hal Lanier or something like that? Who was the catcher for them?
Tommy Haller
was one of the good catchers for the San Francisco Giants. I know my baseball
players.
How
did it make him
feel? Probably bad, but I think Tom Haller played for the Dodgers for a while. So,
Tom Haller. Yeah. Everybody plays for everybody in that game.
Nobody talks about Johnny Roseboro, by the way, as one of the great catchers. Koufax said this, quoting Sandy Koufax, says, to me, John Roseboro was the catcher. Do you hear that? Hear that, AJ Ellis? To me, John Roseboro was the catcher. With him out there, I felt like I was never alone. Now, that's a catcher. That's what great teams need. Strength up the middle. You don't trade away. Next week, we'll talk about this on the show. You don't trade away D. Gordon on the Dodgers and get rid of your strength up the middle. Shortstop, second base, center fielder, catcher. Where are the Dodgers' problems in all those areas now? You know, they get rid of their rookie center fielders out.
I think they're second in Major League Baseball in defense. They corrected a lot of those
defense
problems.
Defense-wise, they're good.
They corrected a lot of offense problems.
Yeah, well, they've got, what's his face there at second base now?
But they don't do anything with it. They don't, they don't do anything with it.
They got Chase out there and they got,
he's alright. He's good.
He made
a great play the other day.
Actually, Jimmy Rollins, Chase Utley.
He made a good play. He is a good arm.
Yeah, they're good. They're good at the defense, but they need to get some hits.
Yeah, well, there's going to be hell to pay if this team doesn't get to the World Series.
Yep. This Dodger, just one other note on this. It was the Dodgers-Giants, August 22nd, 1965, Candlestick Park. There was the heat of a pennant race. There had already been an incident between the Giants' Matty Alou and Roseboro earlier in the series that ended with Marshall screaming at Roseboro from the dugout steps. And Roseboro says, if he doesn't shut his big mouth, he'll get a ball right behind his ear. That's what Roseboro shouted back at Marshall. This is according to the book, The Fight of Their Lives, how Juan Marshall and John Roseboro turned baseball's ugliest brawl into a story of forgiveness and redemption. So then on that Sunday afternoon, after Marshall and Koufax exchanged brushback pitches to Maury Wills and Willie Mays, respectively, that's when they played ball. You go throw at my guy, Maury Wills, I'll throw at your guy, Willie Mays, right? Marshall took it a step further by throwing at Ron Fairley, at which point Roseboro told Koufax he would take care of it. And sure enough, Marshall batting, Roseboro returned the ball to Koufax by throwing it behind Marshall's head, allegedly clipping his ear. Marshall questioned Roseboro, and then Roseboro cursed the pitcher and stepped toward him, at which point Marshall raised the bat above his head and brought it down upon Johnny Roseboro's bare head. That's the incident. That's it. I just recreated it for you.
That's drama. That's it?
That's it.
All right.
Roseboro said, stung the hell out of me, blood everywhere.
Well, you didn't have a baseball bat.
As Coach Steve, that's terrible.
What Sarkisian would say about that.
I was going to say, go get him. Win the game.
Now.
I got to take it to the bed.
Yeah, okay.
Go ahead, Fred Churchill.
Thanks.
Thank you, Coach.
Thanks so much.
Yes.
Well, anyway.
Your impression of Michael Vick was pretty good, by the way.
What was that?
You talk about, we had the thing killing the dogs and all that kind of stuff, and he gets a second shot as the backup coach to Roethlisberger.
Yeah, I mean, the guy was out of jail, and they asked him, and this is before Lurie, the owner of the Eagles, decided to make him the face of the franchise.
Yes, that's
because
right.
Because he says he believes in him, believes in his character. Here's a guy who just butchered a bunch of dogs.
That's right.
And he's now outside the jailhouse, and he's getting ready to walk in. And they said, so here you go, Vic. You're going into jail. What's the deal? I hit a dog in the head. And so into the jailhouse he went for like 6-7 months, what it was, and they made him, they made him read the Lassie story aloud before he went to bed.
No, they did not.
Yeah, they did.
They did not make him read the Lassie story aloud. They did not do that.
To his teammates.
Oh, that's touching. Thank you.
And then when he got out, Lurie now brings him to Philadelphia and puts him up in front of the press.
Yes.
And the press said, gee, how do you feel? I mean, how do you feel from being in jail for 8 months? I've beaten up a dog and setting the dog on fire. I'm so sorry.
Okay. We'll be back with more here. Is that really a quote? Thank you, by the way, for going in the archives, Tomasa. pulling out that soundbite for us. Classic. We've got it all here at CRN. It's the weekend edition of the PM Show on Sports. That's the one of Fred Dreyer. He and Coach Sarkisian will be back with Michael Vick. Stay with us here on CRN.
It's fall flooring season with incredible deals on the hottest styles right now at Lumber Liquidators Fall Flooring Kickoff Sale. Choose from over 400 great floors with over 20 laminate styles like American-made mahogany for just 49 cents a square foot, more than 30 bamboo floors like carbonized bamboo for only $1.59, and over 150 hardwood floors like pre-finished gun stucco for only 99 cents with a dollar off Bellawood, 20% off Dream Home laminates, plus great floors, woodlike tile, vinyl, and more. With 24-month special financing, the Fall Flooring Kickoff Sale is going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
At TIAA Cref, our record sounds like a broken record. We got impressive results in 2013. And 2014, same thing. We're like, hey, weren't we just here? Then 2015, boom, more impressive results. That's the kind of record you'd expect from a company that's created to serve and built to perform. Intelligent investing, powerful results. Visit TIAA.org. TIAA Cref Individual and Institutional Services, LLC. Investing involves risk.
Experience a luxury boutique hotel escape in the heart of Laguna Beach, California, with the finest art gallery, shopping, dining, and nightlife just steps from your door. The heart of Laguna Beach, the edge of the sea. It's the Inn at Laguna Beach. Enjoy our comfortable rooms, blending the style of a timeless beach bungalow with the modern comforts of today. 70 newly appointed guest rooms and suites await you at the Inn at Laguna Beach. Then, relax at the rooftop bar, where you'll indulge in breathtaking views of the ocean. For dining, you'll find libations and local cuisine on the California coastline, including dining at the legendary Las Brisas, a Southern California landmark. The Inn at Laguna Beach. Footsteps from room to village to sea, located in the heart of Laguna Beach. The Inn is within walking distance of all that Laguna Beach has to offer. No car required. The Inn at Laguna Beach. 211 North Coast Highway in Laguna Beach, California. Call 800-544-4479 or visit innatlagunabeach.com.
PM Show, weekend edition on sports from CRN Digital Talk Radio. I'm Michael Horn, along with the star of our show, the Sultan of Safeties, two safeties in one game, the All-Pro defensive end, the acting legend, Fred Dreyer.
Thanks so very much, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to our show. Is this the last segment, by the way?
No, you got a couple of segments. You got time to really...
Oh, okay.
You want to play the sound bites for Steve Sarkisian again?
Yeah, right.
If we get, if the show sort of drops a little bit, give us that pep rally from Steve Sarkisian. Coach Sarkisian can help us out here again, if he would, please.
Get ready to ride on, baby! Let's go!
It pumps me up. I'm ready to go here.
Our coach.
Our coach. The coach of our show. Coach Sarkisian is now the coach of our show. And we've just signed Michael Vick as a backup.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, Mike. He's good. He's the face of the franchise.
He is. It's good. He's the face of the
If Roethlisberger can't do it.
Oh, boy.
If he can't do it, I'm sure Michael Vick can bring, you know, he can bring the cattle back to Abilene.
This is something. I mean, they always say those are bad boys there on the Steelers, and now they got Michael Vick there at it's Dog Appreciation Day, by the way. So I hope Michael Vick
if the Dodgers don't pick things up, I'm gonna have to swing over to a football
pretty quick, right?
Pretty quick, you know.
I'm going hockey right
away.
There's
2 weeks. There's 2 weeks left, and then the college season opens.
Yeah. So who are we liking this year? Do we like?
We like San Diego State.
We do.
Yeah, we do.
Okay.
We like San Diego State in the Mountain West. They're pretty good this year, I think. That's what I heard.
Is that your old alma mater?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes, you had great coaches there. I know we've said this time and time again, but give us the rundown.
Again?
One more time for new listeners. This is who coached Fred Dreyer at San Diego State. This is incredible. Listen to this lineup.
Our head coach was Don Coryell.
Head coach Don Coryell.
Yeah. Defensive coach, John Madden.
John Madden, defensive coach.
Yeah. Offensive line coach, Joe Gibbs.
Joe Gibbs, offensive line coach.
That's correct. Wide receiver, quarterback coach, Rod Dauhauer.
Oh, Rod Dauhauer. I always forget him. That's the one that you always forget to throw in.
Defensive backfield coach, Ernie Zampezi.
Ernie Zampezi. And there you have it. Those five, right?
That's right.
That's a quite a lineup, an impressive lineup, coaching you at San Diego State. Who's coaching them now? Do we know the coach?
Yeah, Rocky Long.
Oh, Rocky Long. Is he good?
He's the old UCLA defensive coordinator.
Oh, okay. There you go.
Rocky. Good coach.
Okay.
Good coach, and people down there like him, and he wins, seven, eight games a year.
Do you get in the old dryer mobile and go down there and watch a game once a year?
I used to.
Yeah? Maybe you and I should go down there. That might be a nice convertible so you could smoke your cigar and it won't offend me.
Oh.
You could just go drive down there and smoke up a storm if you want.
We have to get down there so we can go to the tailgate section.
Yeah. You like that, don't you?
Yeah, I get really drunk before the game starts.
Yeah, we could do that. We go to the tailgate section. We could bring some friends with us.
And then I get to a microphone.
Get ready to ride on, baby. Let's go.
That's really good. Yeah, that's good.
That's what I do.
That's good.
That's what I do.
Yeah.
I grab a microphone right away.
You do. You kind of lead the crowd and get them all ready to go for the game. That's going to be a big year. Who do you like in the pros for football early on here? What do you think?
I have no idea who's worth anything.
Nor do I. I haven't looked yet.
And you know, I saw the highlights of the Tampa Bay game, and they had the kid from Florida State, the Heisman Trophy winner, the guy who was drafted first.
Yep.
You know, that kid. A good athlete, but he's not going to last. He'll be just like Griffin Jr. You know, he's a rag doll now.
Really?
Yeah. These guys that come out of college with these great running skills.
What is the deal?
And
very few
it. They've pretty soon realized, hey, it's pretty nice here in the pocket. I'll just throw the ball out of the pocket. Because there's guys there that are just as fast as they are who outweigh him about 150.
Clout him a few times, yeah.
Yeah, you can't. What's the problem is you've got three or four people on you. Not just one. You just
right
don't
out
get,
of the box.
You just
right.
don't get tackled by some guy on the corner.
You got four guys on you.
You got four or five guys on you, and you're going to get it. It's just a matter of numbers.
You still like scrambling quarterbacks, though, don't you? You like guys that can scramble.
I like guys who can use that skill and not dine out on it. You know, Tarkington and the great scramblers. Archie Manning was a good scrambler.
Yep.
But they didn't really want to run. A couple of times they would, but early on. But as it got on, they want to get the ball out down the field. That's the best way to do it. Roll out, sprint out. They call it a waggle, and a sprint out to the strong side and a waggle to the weak side. And they want to dump the ball off in the flat and make people come up and miss. And they want to create a momentum offensively. And you do that by getting the ball out to the flat, which is a form of the West Coast. You know, the West Coast offense is just the quarterback taking 1,001, 1,002 and dropping the ball off to a back out in the flat or over the middle. They call them A and B circles, A back and B back. They're coming out and they just circle wherever the linebackers are not. They either hunker down in front of them or between them or maybe just behind them or roll out to the flat to the sideline. But the whole idea is to get the ball out and create a momentum. And all it when you look at it, it's an extension of a handoff.
Is that what really? That,
it's an extension of a handoff. You know,
because they roll out and he just gets the ball to them. They
just,
drop it
and
to
you just, it gets the ball out into the flat, putting the pressure on the defense to have to tackle. And this is a terrible tackling league, as we know.
They don't know how to tackle. You've said this time and time
again.
No. Just like in baseball, not knowing the basics, they're throwing away the basics
of
football.
And I will say this. Football season's coming along, and there's going to be the
more injuries.
Unfortunately, the ugly head of concussions will rear its ugly head, as they say.
That's too ugly.
It's not going to be fun, but it should be a good year. Hope everybody's safe and sound.
PM Show with the one and only Fred Dreyer.
What is going on in the financial world? China's devaluing their currency. John Kerry's warning the U.S. may soon lose our reserve currency status. The IMF planning a new world currency. Meanwhile, the U.S. economy is stagnant. El Dorado's Our Economic Future is at Risk. Read a new report What's next for the dollar? That explains what's really going on. Common Sense Solutions for today's upside-down financial world. Get your free copy today. Call now, 800-289-2646. 800-289-2646. Swiss America has been right on the money for decades. Learn the truth about real money. Now is not the time to worry. Now is the time to take action to protect your hard-earned currency. Please read What's Next for the Dollar. It's free. Call 800-289-2646. That's 800-289-2646. Or online, SwissAmerica.com.
Do you owe the IRS money? Do you have years of unfiled returns? Has the IRS garnished your wages or put a lien against your house? The IRS has the power to make you pay back what they claim you owe and will stop at nothing to collect. If you are losing sleep over your IRS tax problem, there is a solution. Call Signature Tax now. Speak with our professionals and feel the weight of your tax burden lifted from your shoulders. Call 800-543-1427 for your free and confidential analysis on ending your tax nightmare. We can help get your life back on track and give you the fresh start you deserve. Our A-plus BBB-rated tax resolution team has over 125 years of combined experience to get you the best deal possible while stopping the IRS dead in their tracks. Call Signature Tax now at 800-543-1427. Call 800-543-1427. Again, that's 800-543-1427. 800-543-1427.
Trying to sell your old car? Instead, donate your vehicle to Heritage for the Blind. Pickup is free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats, whether they run or not. Call right now and receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to over 50 locations. Call 1-800-785-9618. Donate your car today. That's 1-800-785-9618.
The best show in the world is Two Scorpions in a Brandy Glass. I'm Barry Farber. It is nice when you call and say, "Oh, Mr. Farber, I agree with you, but that really gets us nowhere. I want your enmity, hostility. I want your questions." Give me a call right here on The Barry Farber Show. Weekdays, 5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern, right here on CRN Digital Talk Radio.
PM Show, the weekend edition on CRN Digital Talk Radio. I'm Michael Horn, the star of our show is Fred Dreyer. Show is just flowing by here today. Got baseball season going. What about basketball? We haven't talked about that in a while.
Yeah, it's a good thing we're not.
Yeah, I know, because there's not much to talk about in basketball. You talk too much about basketball when it's going. So
we're going to have enough time, you know, here in the next couple months to gear up and talk about Kobe wanting to win one more championship. You know, he made a comment the other day. Probably a couple months ago, before the draft, that he fully intends to get his sixth championship ring. I said, "Well, where are you going to get it?"
No, one.
You think this team is going to?
No.
No. I mean, what team would he have to go to? He's going to have to leave the Lakers. You know, the other rumor is, I don't know how big of a rumor it is, but the other rumor is that he may not leave.
He may just stick around.
No, he just might just say, you know, I played my contract out, and I want to stay here and win, and I'll you know, sign on for less money, you know, $2,000 less. I'll sign on for less money, but I'm going to win a championship. Or they just might just say, you know, why don't you move on?
He might stay there forever. He might. You never can tell.
No, I mean, here's my point. At some point in time, you got to say, no, we don't want you to.
You got
to
hang them up sometime.
And here's
right.
The reason why. You know, we don't want the young players who we're trying to develop to have their own sense of self. We don't want them to spend 82 games watching you play. And that's what'll happen. Did you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah.
I agree with you.
You all right over there?
I'm good. Yeah. I'm just looking at some of the news. Clippers were fined $250,000, you know.
For what? Because they promised him a commercial?
They were trying to recruit DeAndre Jordan back to the team. Red Sox, if you're a Boston Red Sox fan, apparently they're very unhappy that the New England Sports Network, NESN, has decided to part ways with their longtime play-by-play voice, Don Orsillo, after 15 seasons.
Oh.
Don Orsillo. And that, you know, back the east reason? They get really
what's the reason?
Well, they said the fans have taken to the internet and they've put electronic signatures out there, but his partner, Arceo's partner Jerry Remney, has been in the booth for 15 years, choked up when he was talking about Arceo on Tuesday night.
Jerry Remy?
Jerry Remy.
Yeah.
And so after Fuhrer had settled, Nesson praised Orsillo in an outstanding broadcaster. They extended their appreciation to Don, but the network has not given a corporate concrete explanation for his decision not to renew his contract.
Yeah, they don't have to. And Remy better look out because he could be next.
He could be the next guy going, right?
Yeah.
So so that's kind of sad news there. The Dodgers are looking to maybe fix up their bullpen by bringing up people from the minor leagues. Battingley is talking to team president Andrew Friedman. I think I'd do a better job. They're looking to get some of their top prospects up there. They got this guy, Urias, coming in there,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, those guys.
Julio Urias maybe in there.
I'm shaking in my boots.
Jeriel Cotton and Chris Anderson.
Shaking in my
coming
boots.
Up. So we'll have to see if they can square the, right the ship, so to speak. That's our show, yes.
Is that it?
Wait, you had one more thing. You said this something, what?
I was going to say something.
What?
Do I have time? I've got a minute.
Yeah.
I have a minute. I don't have good feelings about the Dodgers. I don't have good feelings about it.
Let's next really week talk don't. About that. Do you want to gather all your feelings together and bring them right here
I have
lay
feelings.
Them down?
I have feelings.
I know you do.
I have feelings. I want to
you're
share.
You're warm and fuzzy and wonderful
share.
Guy.
I want to share my feelings. But at the same time, I want to be realistic. I hate falling prey to my feelings and being a sap. You know what I mean?
Yeah. That's why you should tweet more often and follow Fred on Twitter.
Oh, yeah. Fred underscore Dreyer.
Dreyer.
I've been tweeting Dreyer. Like crazy. This Donald Trump thing is, I'm so delirious.
I love this. It's great.
What he's doing to the Republican Party, they should have happened 35 years ago.
Email
Reagan
Fred, Dreyer at crntalk.com. That's our show. Final thoughts?
Final thoughts is I'll be going to the dentist pretty soon for my cleaning.
CRN Digital Talk Radio prides itself on being the station of every situation. Of course, you can always listen live through your local cable TV provider, as well as on our website at crntalk.com. But if cutting-edge technology is more your style, you'll be happy to know that CRN is now available on Wi-Fi radio. Simply log on to receiva.com.